J.J. Abrams, Bad Robot, it's a big deal. You know, they've had much success in a lot of their films, so just having the opportunity to be a part of it was something that I wanted to take very seriously. So from day one, when it came down to reading the script and auditioning up until now, I wanted to, you know, put my best foot forward and do the best job I could. The biggest thing that I enjoy about the movies that come from Bad Robot and J.J. is just the surprise element. You know, the mystery from their stories. You know, they have very interesting stories and complex characters. So, you know, it was an opportunity that I wasn't going to let slip from my hands if I could help it. It's about a company of paratroopers who are given a mission to drop into this French village and to take out an element of the German military. But like you said, they are presented with another element of the military that they weren't expecting to encounter, and we are all just doing our best to above all else get the mission done with these dire circumstances. I think that people will find straight off the bat that he doesn't fit into the Motley crew. Who are all, or many of them, are seasoned soldiers, and Boyce is just trying to keep up and trying to fit in the best way he's able to. We have Boyce, and he has a couple of guys in the group that he considers friends. I would say Chase and Jacob. You know, those are two guys that I think Boyce has from basic training up into jump school up until now. These are guys that he was really close to. And then we have, you know, Tibbet. I don't think that Boyce and Tibbet are really close, but, you know, they are in the same company, so they work together the best way they can. So a lot of the time, the guys may butt heads a lot as far as ideas and as far as how to go about continuing this mission. But, you know, when you're met with opposition, you know, great men try to break those barriers down and get the job done. When you're dealing with this type of film where the brotherhood element and the relationships are incredibly important, I think that time spent is something that's invaluable, and it's something that can't be faked. You know, I think it's something that needs to be nurtured, and it should come organically. So when I found out that we were doing the boot camp, I was incredibly excited. I took some time in Los Angeles to learn about the different weapons we'd be using and got a chance to fire off a few. And that was really, really cool. And when we got here to England, I think that first day of going to boot camp, nobody knew exactly what to expect. And our sergeant, Freddie, he was very bleak about what we're going to encounter and just very grim about the whole thing. And I think a lot of us were really terrified. But it was difficult, it was confusing, it was stressful, but I think it was necessary to really bring us together. And I think that relationship that we earned, because I think it absolutely needed to be earned, I think that it will show up on screen because we put the time in. It was just the first scene that we would have the whole company, you know, not just the main guys, but the entire group of GIs. So and the set that they built was incredible, you know, with the C model plane, and just being in the exact, you know, replicated plane, you know, having this, you know, coming in with all of the equipment and the parachutes that weighed a ton. It was one of the most uncomfortable elements of the shoot, but it, like I said before, puts you in to the mindset of what these soldiers possibly had to go through. And, you know, because of course we could never relate shooting a film to the real life experience, but us being able to sit in their shoes just for pretend was enough. I think that, you know, Bad Robot and the producers and Julius really helped us by having us have physical sets and these grand sets that we could really escape to and really fall into the character and the circumstances. I mean, you can always see the concept art and see what they have as far as ideas, but it was incredible just to really see. It was like everything that they imagined it to be based off of the concept art was just taken straight into reality. So it was very creepy, and, you know, the prosthetics, I didn't like looking at the actors very long who had those in because it just looked so disgusting. But like I said, it serves the story, and it's gonna be an incredible presentation for the audience when they see it. This is a very large project, and, you know, it's very ambitious in the elements of the story, and Julius is the perfect director for it. From the first audition that I had with him, he was very open, and he presented different takes on the scenes that I hadn't hadn't even considered. And, you know, the exercises that we did in the audition room, from that day I knew that he was the director that I wanted to work with and that I wanted to, you know, go through the fire with, so to speak. So from day one, walking on set, seeing the sets and the table reads and the boot camps, I mean, Julius has always been our leader from the first day and coming to the end now. He's always been the one that's, you know, allowed the actors to feel comfortable exploring the unorthodox and trying to find new complex and interesting ways to play out scenes day in and day out. It's a story about humanity, and it's about the preservation of humanity and rooting for the underdog. I mean, when you meet boys, he's just cut from a different cloth than a soldier. You know, he was a student first, so I think that people will find it interesting to follow, you know, Boyce and witness this entire journey from his point of view. And, you know, I think people will root for him and the rest of the guys to really complete the mission and to save these people. There are two very specific genres that have been seamlessly meshed into this film. So I think people will walk in not knowing quite what to expect. I don't think that they'll be going in to see a Band of Brothers or a Saving Private Ryan or things like that. I think it's very much an action adventure, but it's in the setting of the Second World War. So I think there are a lot more surprises in there. There are much more things that can and will go wrong in this mission, and we just have to find our best way to get the job done.